presidential seal of approval. Fourth game in 4 days for Georgetown. Third game in 3 days for West Virginia. They were one of the top four seeds, so they had a double bye, and the Mountaineers controlled the tip.
Sean McDonough, Jay Billis. The Hoyas go.
And a designed play, but Aaron pass as Ebanks tried to lob one up for Butler for a dunk. Then Butler teed up a long jumper that didn't go, and Bryant lost it in the lane. Austin Freeman, Georgetown's leading scorer for the year, just under 17 a game. In for Julian Vaughn in traffic. Too strong with the jump hook. As Doris mentioned, Daryl Bryant from the New York area, and he has struggled at home in this building. They played St. John's here during the regular season and the two games here in this Big East tournament, and Daryl Bryant is 2 for 19 from the floor. So he went out today with his mother and bought some new shoes, trying to change his luck.
Say some prayers. Of course, when they get point play, they're pretty solid.
Deshaun Butler had it rattle out, and then another rebound for Greg Monroe. He's averaged 18 points, more than 10 rebounds, and more than 5 assists in the 3 games that Georgetown has won to get to this point.
Wellington Smith with the matchup, Jay, on Monroe.
Good defender, very athletic.
Chris Wright's been red hot. He's averaged a team-high 19 points in their 3 wins. They beat South Florida by 20 on Wednesday. Then they beat number 1 Syracuse, the regular season champs, ranked number 3 in the country, on Thursday by 7. And then they hammered Marquette by 23 last night. And good hands on defense by Freeman.
Anytime Monroe gets the ball, even if it's up a little bit higher, he's going to pass it off, and they come off those men up high very effectively for handoffs, or they can go back door. And Chris Wright is an outstanding shooter and very, very strong.
Wellington Smith missed a 3 for a big man. He can make that, almost 38% for the year from 3. It'll be Georgetown ball with 29 to shoot. John Thompson the third says, my team is playing very well right now. Chris Wright says, when we're good, we can beat anybody in the country. His shot blocked by Wellington Smith. He also pointed out they can lose to anybody in the country. Georgetown has been up and down this year. They lost in the regular season to Rutgers.
Nice screen.
And Jason Clark swoops to the bucket.
Jason, the pieces have gotten better, Sean. That's what makes this team an improved one.
Even when they're trying to enter the ball to the elbow, they can still drive hard off that elbow. That was really well done by Jason Clark.
Clark's a sophomore from Arlington, Virginia, because Wright and Monroe in particular have been so outstanding. Clark hasn't gotten much attention here, but he's averaged 16 points per game in the 3 wins. Good spin to the baseline. And Kevin Jones was fouled by Greg Monroe, his first.
Now I'm taking this replay because you could never use your left. Jason, with the ability to blow by, man, and you're right. They use the center to dribble handoff for a slapback 3, dribble handoff, turn the corner, and you're right, that little screen, an explosion to the goal.
2 solid games here for Kevin Jones. Double points. Double figures in points in both of those games, despite the fact they were both low scoring. Bob Huggins, 75 wins in 3 years at his alma mater, and he's won 9 conference tournament championships. He's coached in 9 conference tournaments in different leagues. This is his 6th different league that he's coached in a conference tournament, 37-12 all time.
Of automatic switching because of the size on the perimeter.
Austin Freeman short with a 3. And Deshaun Butler picked it off the floor. Bob Huggins also said before the game, imagine how good we'd be if we could make a shot. And he's still looking for his first field goal of the night.
Georgetown switching everything, even those little exchanges at the nail, the kind of curl screen that is very difficult to guard.
And Vaughn can contain anybody. The big guy moves the puppies beautifully.
Jason Clark called for his first foul.
Vaughn really did a nice job of moving his feet against Marquette, those quick guards.
zone look here, huh?
2-3 zone out of bounds underneath. A lot of teams do that.
Yes, it may not be a bad idea, but on the long jumpers, you must rebound if you're Georgetown.
The out of the corner wouldn't go for Jones. Still no field goals for West Virginia.
Good job by Smith to get Monroe off that low block. He won't let him catch it where he wants to.
They do a great job fundamentally all over the floor.
But when they cut back door, you have got to stay low, turn your head, and keep that hand in a passing lane, because they throw it late and they throw it low. It's always a bounce pass.
Nice kick.
Monroe's open for three. Made one yesterday. Not tonight. Monroe has made.
Exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by New York Life, helping keep your family safe and secure. And in part by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's.
Back in New York City for the Big East Championship. West Virginia looking for the first Big East tournament title in school history against Georgetown. Mountaineers haven't made a shot yet. They're 0 for 4 from the floor. Three of those four shots have been three-pointers. Georgetown trying to do what only two other teams have ever done, win the Big East tournament while playing four games in 4 days. Pittsburgh did it in 08. Syracuse the first to do it back in 2006, the memorable run fueled by Jerry McNamara. So perhaps a disadvantage in that regard for Georgetown. This is their fourth game in 4 days. For West Virginia, just their third in three because of the double bye.
Of course, we played 5 days. A little different, though, our performance.
We're
pre and post.
Work quite as strenuously as these young men do.
No, absolutely.
A lot of screens to get Jones down in that low block. Screen for the screener, then a cross screen.
Yeah, Wellington Smith dragging Monroe. Sort of helps the box people.
Times when West Virginia's half-court offense can look very ugly, they, as you guys have noted, don't have a lot of players who can penetrate and help create offense that way. They settle for another three, and it's a miss. Monroe ahead of the field. The big man can run the floor and handle it, and he laid it in.
He's such a catalyst. I mean, he reads and understands. His feel for this game is extraordinary. He knew they were getting the rebound. Why not leak out?
He is 6'11", 250 pounds. And so agile.
Screen and pop.
Ebanks traveled.
Well, that walk was made by Monroe sticking in the lane, but on the rebound he just takes off. He was already on the perimeter, and even though Truck Bryant tries to take the ball away, he's got the awareness to pick it up and still not walk and finish the play. Just a big time player that is starting to assert himself and take over.
Jason Clark for Georgetown. The Hoyas 23-9 overall. They were 10-8 in the Big East regular season, the eighth seed, but they played the toughest schedule in the country. Strength of schedule number one. They're number 7 in the RPI. Monroe again, all the way to the goal, and it's 8-1 Hoyas.
A hesitation move, and then the blue line.
Well, the ball movement, and everybody attacked the closeout, especially Monroe.
West Virginia 26-6. They've won 5 in a row coming in, 7 of 8, 13 out of 16, and they won 13 games in the Big East regular season. That is the school record. 13-5 to earn the number 3 seed. And finally a field goal. 6 minutes in, it's Kevin Jones.
And Missoula the one. He got it going. Drive in the lane, get a foot in the painted area, the kick, and then the ball reversal.
And then Smith punched the lane right after that.
Missoula saw most of the action in place of Daryl Bryant in the second half at crunch time last night against Notre Dame. And he was a spark off the bench. Joe had the ball there, gave it to Wellington Smith. Missoula had a season-high 8 points last night in 23 minutes. Butler long, Clark the rebound.
But he bobbled a little on the catch.
And boy, he throws you. It's interesting. If you don't catch it well or it's not passed well, it really deters your ability to shoot.
And you wonder about the pressure on West Virginia. They're all New Yorkers. They're trying to do something the school has never done before.
Well, you might be right, except with Butler. He just seems to deliver.
Shot clock down to 6. Monroe, good defense. by Wellington Smith.
Greg Monroe staying out on the perimeter, and everybody attacking the closeout. Wright attacking Smith, and then Monroe attacking yet again.
I think you're shocked if you're guarding him, the efficiency and speed that he maneuvers with.
Cam Thurman's into the ball game for West Virginia. 4 seconds to shoot as they inbound it, and Wright was fouled. They got it in right under the basket, and Mazzulla called for the foul, his first.
The guy that's guarding the inbounds man has got to take that away. You have to take away middle and underneath the basket and make them inbound it to the corner on the short side of the floor.
Chris Wright, team leading 19 points in the 3 wins here. He had a Big East high for him this season, 27 points in that win over Syracuse, where they had a 22-4 run in the second half to come from behind and beat the Orange, a team that defeated them twice during the regular season. Wright says they're playing with a chip on their shoulders. They've been more aggressive in this tournament. They're attacking people. And he believes, as many do, with three future NBA players himself, Monroe and Freeman, this is a team that has a talent to win the whole thing, not just this thing, but the NCAA tournament. Thurman fed Jones for the bucket.
And a nice setup on the bottom. A little stack set up and then a slip to the tin. And Thurman has been very efficient.
You have to expect Thurman's
pretty. What a beautiful pass.
Oh, wow. If you just count the house, that kid reads it and delivers a bounce pass. 6'10".
Anytime somebody cuts backdoor, you've got to turn your head defensively and keep your hand down, because those are always going to be bounce passes. Backdoor cuts, they never throw an air pass.
How many guys have you seen get a piece of those passes, though? It's almost impossible.
It's tough.
Yeah.
Butler, tough shot and too strong with the bank, but Thurman's there and he puts it back up and in. Cam Thurman in the right spot. He averages less than a point per game in about 7.5 minutes per game.
Yeah, he's going to get his money's worth too with Monroe. He's going to fight him, particularly in the low box area.
Monroe went by Thurman and was bumped by Jones as he got underneath the basket. Boy, he's putting it on the floor and powering his way to the hoop. Congratulations to Coach Fisher and San Diego State. Here it's Georgetown by 4, led once again out of the gate by Greg Monroe.
He's just got the complete package. We talked about his ability to run the floor and the awareness to take the ball away from somebody trying to reach in and knock it away. And he can drive it from the perimeter. He catches it at that elbow. And if you cut, he's going to find you. He's got a great understanding of the game. He's poised and he has superior vision. It's like he sees a pass ahead of what's going on out on the floor.
He's omniscient, or whatever that means.
I'm not sure that's
he's
a word,
knowing.
But if it is, perhaps he is that. Here's
that
Doris Burke.
Guys, if there has been a criticism of the next level guys at the NBA watching Greg Monroe, it's that they wonder if on a night-by-night basis he's ready to be a game changer. But Jay and Sean, I'm curious, and Bill, have you ever seen him this emotional? I think the thing I liked best about him last night, it wasn't when he scored that he reacted with such great enthusiasm. It was when he set his teammates up that he reacted with great enthusiasm.
Yeah, that's a great point, Doris. I mean, I said the other day, and it probably didn't make a whole lot of sense, but he unselfishly dominates a game.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he can take advantage of his matchup, but when somebody gets open, he finds them, and he draws so much attention, and he always looks in the right place. You know, if he catches the ball, he gets doubled, he looks opposite. He's a big-time player.
Butler scored for West Virginia off a setup from Mazzulla. Then good hands and hustle by Mazzulla. But Wright got it back, and Freeman's open for a three. And snatched out of the air by Devin Ebanks.
Nice hustle by Mazzulla. Should have just eaten the ball.
Wellington Smith ties it up. West Virginia got in a big early hole. They're out of it quickly.
And Ebanks, as you mentioned, big-time snatch, but also patience coming up, not jacking up a deep one, finding a better shooter.
But how about the way Mazzulla took that pass away, turned his head, dropped his hand and stayed with it on that bounce pass.
He'll fight you, Jay. Tough kid. Gonna push from the back.
Yeah, it's a good call by Pat Driscoll. Thurman trying to be clever, gave Monroe a little nudge in the middle of the back, just enough to throw him off.
Oh, what a nice look, huh? The setup by Butler, but Mazzulla knowing right away what he's going to do here. Late, he banks the delay game, and they slap back as well as anybody in the country with the trail man.
Thurman called for his first foul, and he's gone to the bench. Here's Chris Wright, and the rebound comes down to Dennis Kolicla, freshman from Turkey, who hasn't seen much action in these first two games for West Virginia.
Look at his side there. He's got a nice little game with the hooks and a physical player. He can wrap his hands around all of us.
Mazzulla bumped a couple of nights ago after their narrow victory against Cincinnati when Butler was the hero at the buzzer. Bob Huggins had a conversation with Mazzulla. Said, you're not playing with your usual enthusiasm and energy, and that's your greatest value to our team. And he was back to his usual energetic self last night and was a key to their narrow win against Notre Dame.
Do you think he said it that calmly?
I doubt it.
Agreed.
Well, you don't have to guard Mazzulla out on the perimeter because he's not going to hit a perimeter shot, but that doesn't mean that if they're playing off, he can't take up that space, still get an angle and drive it to the basket. He did a great job of doing that against Notre Dame, and thus far in the ball game, he's been able to drive it.
But also that drive set him up for the Butler entry with a couple of bounces deep on the foul line.
He's 46% for the year from the free throw line coming in, but he's been recovering from shoulder surgery. For a while he was shooting the ball with the other hand because of the shoulder. He's now made 9 of his last 11 free throws, so that percentage will come up quickly. 7 straight points for West Virginia. They've gone from 8-1 behind to start the game to the lead. Right a little short. Monroe's out of the ball game right now for Georgetown. A held ball on the floor. Jarrell Benneman has it in his hands for the Hoyas, and what's the call?
I'm watching Kolicla, Jay, and he showed big, put his arms big, go running down the lane. It's amazing how quickly he's picked up some of the defensive principles.
And Wright just drove right off of him and almost used Kolicla as a screen. But Kolicla's got to make sure he rebounds. That's his real value. He's got to be able to rebound the basketball.
Georgetown got it back after a held ball call. This is Hollis Thompson. And a few subs you'll see. That's the other part of this 4 games and 4 nights for Georgetown. They get only 7.8 points per game off the bench. That's the lowest bench point total of any team in the country. And the starters play about 80% of the minutes, give them 89% of their points. But they knew when the year started it was going to be a very short bench, and they've been conditioning physically, mentally, emotionally since the summertime to prepare for major minutes from the starters, and it really hasn't seemed to faze them at all.
Well, they're tough kids, and they know what it's all about. They're reaching back, making up for the end of last year. What a great defensive trip by West Virginia. They get an offensive foul.
Clark just leaned into that screen. All he's got to do is set it and let Chris Wright come off of it.
Not easy to score against West Virginia, so you've got to meet that at the other end as well.
With the lack of depth, they can't afford foul difficulty, and Clark has 2 with 9 minutes to go, and Monroe's going to return. More than midway through the first half, West Virginia by 2. These teams played once in the regular season, the final big Monday of the year, March 1st in Morgantown. Whoa, how about that finish by Wellington Smith? West Virginia won that ball game in Morgantown 81-68, but both coaches seem to say you could throw out the result because Georgetown played that game without Austin Freeman. It was right when he was in the midst of not feeling well and wound up being diagnosed as a diabetic.
Georgetown got down early. They had to chase. You're right. I don't think that result is going to mean much in this game.
Literally didn't rebound, but he's screening off.
Off the Clark miss. It's Butler for 3. Long rebound, run down by Wellington Smith in the corner. He's in trouble, found Butler, and then Clark knocked it back off of Butler and out of bounds.
And those hustle plays, but Mazzulla getting deep in the lane earlier. And how about this one, trying to slam it home? A little crawler at MSG.
Freeman for Thompson. Monroe is back on the court for Georgetown. John Flowers has come in, number 41 for West Virginia. Another long body. Freeman went right by him and scored.
And what a great job. They fronted the post so Jones couldn't help. And the strength off the bounce by Freeman. Extraordinary.
If West Virginia's Bryant were already named Truck, Freeman would be able to take that nickname. He is unbelievably strong.
I call him Diesel.
Such a good shooter for a guard. Mm-hmm. Freeman's 53% from the floor for the season and 45% from three. Flowers doesn't shoot often, doesn't score often, but he rattled that one home. The average is about three a game for Coach Huggins.
He brings a little energy, doesn't he? And a few dance steps, I might add, as we saw in the open.
Backdoor cut, then the ball screen.
Look at the defense, though. Great help. Flowers there, and Casey went to the middle.
Beautiful week of weather here in New York. A nasty day in Manhattan. Heavy rain, windswept rain all day inside Madison Square Garden. It's West Virginia by four as we go inside the play.
Blob defense, that's baseline out of bounds defense. And this man, Deshaun Butler, has got to keep that ball from coming into the middle. He needs to shade more toward the basket. This pass cannot be made. He's got to make it come to the short side of the floor, out to the corner. Instead, it goes under the basket, layup, foul. One of the only things Deshaun Butler has done less than perfect in this whole tournament.
He's not a good blob.
He's not a good blob defender.
He missed that meeting this morning, another scouting report.
As Bill might say, he's not omniscient.
Uh-huh. I knew you would pass up the opportunity, no matter what stage or level.
Truck Bryant back in now for West Virginia.
2-3 zone.
And I would do this a few more trips. I know they like to do it on the baseline out of bounds, but see if they can make shots, see if you can chase the rebound.
Wellington Smith, he's been outstanding so far tonight for West Virginia. Senior trying to finish his career with a Big East title. He and Butler are the two winningest players in the history of West Virginia University. Deshaun Butler has been a part of 102 wins, more than any other player in school history. And Smith's right behind him on that list. It's Julian Vaughn inside for Georgetown.
And they do over hustle or over help, and that clean the glass. Trying to one more trip, they score, he'll get out of this. Coaches just don't have confidence giving up easy looks.
Well, you have to be patient in this defense. It may hit a couple shots, but if you're going to play it, you can stay in it for a little while.
And West Virginia patient attacking it. Perhaps they just haven't found a good option yet. Under 10 now to shoot. Bryant. So far, the new shoes aren't helping the shooting in the garden.
Well, that'll keep them in the zone, too. That's not what you want. Got a foul line entry earlier. Move the ball.
The post defense has been excellent by West Virginia. They are not letting the ball down on the low block. And there have not been many catches at the elbow.
Hollis Thompson for three, the freshman from Los Angeles. Highly recruited, picked Georgetown over Duke, USC, UCLA, and Arizona, among others. And he's a good three-point shooter, better than 40%.
And one of those pieces that has gotten better.
Kevin Jones running the baseline, trying to get behind that zone.
They are big on that baseline, aren't they? Vaughn Thompson, that worked earlier.
Jones well off, tipped around, controlled by Flowers, peeled off the rim nicely by Julian Vaughn, transfer from Florida State. Freeman looked like he was going to take a shot for a second. He was still on the logo at center court.
You got to be a threat, as this kid is.
Yeah, right, just about on that logo, missed it. Wellington Smith, another rebound. Well, here come the Mountaineers, 4:20 to go in the half. West Virginia leading by one.
They overload and flash high.
Hey,
3-second violation. Maybe the first one this week. Championship week continues on ESPN and ABC Sunday. Two conference championship matchups at 1 Eastern on ESPN. Georgia Tech takes on the top-seeded Duke in the ACC championship, subject to blackouts in ACC markets. And at 1 Eastern on ABC, Mississippi State faces Kentucky for the SEC title. Championship week presented by Dick's Sporting Goods. Block shot.
How about that, huh? Jones just contributes in such a solid fashion.
And the quick hitter out of the corner wouldn't go, but Butler is right there. And they're going to count the basket for Deshaun Butler.
Sean, we always have said the danger is offensive rebounding, particularly on the weak side. This team loads up two and sometimes three, and Butler providing the lift with the finish. Woo. Jones, excuse me, Ebanks, I had Jones with the block.
The Deshaun Butler is one of the great players in West Virginia history, and another milestone for this highly decorated player. That bucket just before the timeout gives him 4 points tonight and an even 2,000 for his career. Just the third player in West Virginia history to reach that milestone, and the other two are two of the all-time greats. Jerry West, one of the great figures in the history of basketball, and Hot Rod Hundley, who just recently had his number retired in Morgantown.
I happened to be down there when it happened, and he took a hook shot after the ceremony, and son of a gun, Rod made it. The place went crazy.
From how far out?
Just like off the box, you know, Jay's range.
2001 now for Deshaun Butler after the free throw. It's a 4-point lead.
Pretty.
Beautiful offense. Wright lays it in off a setup from Austin Freeman.
Boy, Wellington Smith made it so difficult for Monroe to catch the ball. I mean, you certainly don't want to give up a backdoor cut, but keeping it away from Monroe, an important factor in West Virginia's defense against Georgetown.
Back to the straight up man. They do a nice job protecting the off baseline. Tough shot.
And he made it from the elbow with two Georgetown defenders nearby. Deshaun Butler with 7.
A spin and a jab step and step back.
And Sean's comment to one on one side, one on the other, to try and deter.
Freeman, tough one, a little short with a left hand. Veneman crashed the board but didn't get it for Georgetown. Smith running the floor, knew the contact was coming. Jones in the right spot, as he so often is. Kevin Jones, single season West Virginia record with 115 offensive rebounds entering tonight. He had the exact same number on the defensive end, 115 of each. That's unusual when you have as many offensive rebounds as you do defensive, but he's so great on that offensive glass.
Well, they ran the break beautifully. Ebanks giving it up early.
Freeman was fouled as he probed the side of the lane.
Ebanks made a mistake reaching there. But look at this defense by Ebanks, just making Austin Freeman finish over his length.
And this really is the one earlier, Jay. How about this? Ugh. Tough.
Beautiful.
Such confidence right now.
Last foul on Wellington Smith, his first, and Georgetown takes a timeout with 2:02 to go in the first half, down by 6. ABC is your home for the NBA Sunday Showcase. And tomorrow, two of the top teams in the Eastern Conference battle in Cleveland. It's King James and the Cavaliers hosting Kevin Garnett and the Celtics. The NBA Sunday Showcase. Celtics-Cavaliers on ABC, 3:30 Eastern, 12:30 Pacific. Coverage begins at 3 with the GMC Sierra NBA Countdown.
And, Sean, I pay my usual homage to this guy. I got him in the Hall of Fame, and Jay and I had a great story he told us, right? Derrick Jackson, one of his lead guards. Now a minister. He has one picture in his office. What is it?
In 1976, playing in the ECAC for a chance to go to the NCAA tournament, Jackson hit a shot to win the game, and the guy that caught the ball through the net was Bob Huggins. And Thompson had a picture in his office all these years of Huggins holding that ball, and he likes to tell Bob about it. About all these years later, he had a picture in his office of Bob Huggins wearing his West Virginia uniform with that ball.
Relishes it.
And Bob was a fine player at West Virginia, team captain in the mid and late 70s, academic All-American, and Wright traveled. Turned a pass, didn't find Hollis Thompson open, and he dragged his foot. Huggs, magna cum laude, two-time academic All-American, captain as a senior for Coach Jody Gardner. Bob has a master's, Morgantown native, but he grew up in Ohio. How about all the legendary figures who grew up around his hometown? He told us Cy Young about 3 miles away, Woody Hayes about 5 miles away in Midvale.
Amazing. I don't think he found that story amusing of John Thompson's, by the way. Take that picture down, big fella.
Magna cum laude. Omniscient.
Pretty.
Yeah.
I'm missing.
Slightly more omniscient than Bill. Thurman to Ebanks. And the lead is 8, the largest of the night for Huggs and the Mountaineers.
What's been really impressive is West Virginia's defense. Thurman again not letting Monroe catch it at the elbow where he wants to get it.
Right. Rushed by Thurman. Are they going to count it?
I think they will.
It appears they will. Ed Corbett says score the goal for Georgetown.
Using just a little brush, and again, the strength we talk about, Freeman, a little kiss by Wright, who can do very little wrong. And Thurman, once again, finding people at home, that little action below and slip to the rim, and he has been thorough in his play.
Well, Benjamin guarding him as if he's going to throw the ball to the corner. Who cares if he throws it there? He got to take away middle.
Wright, one of 3 McDonald's All-Americans on this Georgetown team, Monroe and Freeman, also honored in that way while they were in high school. 9 points for Chris Wright. Georgetown back within 5. 1 minute to go, first half. Big East championship game. West Virginia trying to win it for the first time. And Georgetown for the 8th. Mazzulla to the bucket. Tipped by Butler. And scooped up by Monroe. 2 Hoyas ahead of the play. And it's Wright. And he was fouled. They have Monroe playing out of position. He should be the point guard.
Well, the problem is Mazzulla went to the rim and no balance in the floor. And that made this look, you're right, why not, Sean?
Oh, my goodness, is he so good with the ball in his hands.
How about the elevation by the little guy? Send it in, number 4. You can't miss with that delivery.
He just exploded off the floor.
He is very powerfully put together at 6'1", 208. His second 3-point play. Within just a couple of seconds, here come the Hoya fans as they run off 6 straight points from Chris Wright. Timeout, West Virginia. 39.6 to go in the first half. Third, as the Hoyas in the Big East title game for the 3rd time in the last 4 years, and his team has momentum on its side right now. Monroe to Wright, and it's Georgetown back within 2. 39.6 to go in the half.
And Sean, Jay compared him to Jameer Nelson, and I agree, the body, the strength, goodness, like on a trampoline, exploding to the rim.
I think he's a better shooter than Nelson.
I don't know if he has that range that Nelson had, but you may be right on a consistent basis.
Well, Litchell in the middle of the lane, and he's being bumped by Vaughn. He's also in the lane a long time. It's the first foul on Julian Vaughn and the 16th foul. The officials have pretty much let them play here in the first half, and it's been fun to watch. It's been a very well-officiated Big East championship all week.
I would agree. Got to get it in.
Foul to the benefit of West Virginia. Now the shot clock's off, and they can take it all the way down for the final shot if they choose.
Rebound. Litchler can do some damage with that body.
Gotta watch where Butler is.
Under 10, and they start to go. Litchler with the left, and again, jammed in from the weak side by Wellington Smith. Three-quarter court heave. Just wide left from Chris Wright. Pulsating action at the end of that first half. And as they head to the locker room, it's West Virginia by 4. 9 points for Wellington Smith. And here's Doris Burke with Bob Huggins.
We've got to get his attention back. Coach Huggins, after a slow start offensively, you started to get going. What changed for you on that end?
Well, we were playing around the three-point line and not attacking them. And, you know, we changed what we did to try to throw the ball a little closer. You know, we are what we are. You know, we've got to get the ball close. We've got to rebound the ball. We've got to sit down and guard. And then for us to shoot shots around the perimeter does nothing lead to but transition baskets for them. And we're not the best transition team. So we've got to make them play the way we want to play.
Georgetown will test you defensively. What did you think of what you guys did on defense?
Well, I thought we played really hard. You know, we gave up a couple back cuts, which we didn't give up the last time. They throw it really late. You know, they throw it later than anybody who runs back cuts, and we kind of gave up on it a little bit too early.
Coach, thank you.
Thank you.
Sean.
Two of the strongest teams in the country, Kevin Jones and West Virginia, 4-point lead at the break. Reese Digger and Hubert, the Cisco Halftime Report. This event brought to you by New York Life. At halftime in the championship game, it is a 4-point lead for the West Virginia Mountaineers. Welcome back, Sean McDonough, Jay Billis, Bill Raftery. It was a great start for Georgetown. They got off to an 8-1 advantage. It looked like Greg Monroe was going to dominate the proceedings again. Thereafter, West Virginia did a very good job on him. He scored only 1 point the rest of the half.
They did a remarkable job. Early on, they were able to rotate over, block a shot. They are not letting him catch it at the elbow or the low block where he wants to catch it. And Wellington Smith has done a magnificent job of fighting him down on the low block and at the elbow. That is where he gets that offense started and where he is so effective.
I'll tell you though, Wellington Smith, offensively solid, 4 for 7, 9 points, 1 assist, 2 blocks, 6 rebounds.
Whew. And you can see the touches that Greg Monroe has gotten. He has not been able to get them where he wants them, that at the elbow and the low block. That has been a big key to this game for West Virginia defensively.
West Virginia ball to begin the second half. Butler rifled a pass underneath. And Kevin Jones scored. He has 10. And West Virginia's lead now 6. Let's welcome in Doris Burke.
John Thompson III took one look at me and said, second chance points. He had 9 offensive rebounds, turned it into 10 second chance points. He said, listen, we could be stronger with the ball, but they're getting too deep post position. The Duckins are killing us. We've got to stop them offensive rebounding, guys.
Monroe, a miss from in close. Joe Mazzulla, the redshirt junior from Johnston, Rhode Island, the other way for West Virginia. And he is bumped before the shot. And let's take a look at our first half statistics brought to you by New York Life.
And the rebounding differential in part because of the offensive boards, and the other part, they've done a good job on the defensive boards. But Doris is right. Second chance points, that's what West Virginia does. They are a great offensive rebounding team. They get about 42% of their own misses on the season.
The rebounding margin, second best in the Big East, just behind Cincinnati. Mazzulla will throw it in deep for Wellington Smith. As Bill mentioned, he was outstanding in the first half. Now Mazzulla with Ebanks, Jones, and Butler in a kick ball. And they'll play it out of bounds near midcourt, nearly a minute into the second half.
A little 2-3 zone look, which we've seen quite a bit on the baseline, out of bounds. Pop to the post there. Jay, how about the pass by Butler? He's got the great look on that jump shot out of the half and finds his partner underneath in better position.
And Jones was looking for it instead of just going to the offensive glass. He was alert to it. With this 2-3 zone, that way Georgetown doesn't have to chase all the cuts that West Virginia can throw on him in that 5-out motion.
Yeah, they drag up the big guy though. It opens up rebounding.
It looked like Jones and Wellington Smith knocked the ball away from each other at the offensive glass off the Butler miss. And Georgetown almost lost the handle out of bounds. Austin Freeman, Jason Clark, Julian Vaughn, Greg Monroe, and Chris Wright, same 5 to play most of the game for Georgetown. Begins the second half. Clark and Aaron 3. Smith a rebound. Stumbles as he got tangled with Monroe. 3-on-2. Mazzulla blocked by Vaughn. out of bounds, last touched by Jones. Jones thought it hit a Hoy on the way out, but he didn't get the call.
Now, there's a little bit better serve to give it to Evans because of the size factor. And pretty good defense, giving ground, a little fake and recover. Very tough for the guard to dominate that high.
And Vaughn waits until Mazzulla commits and leaves the floor before he leaves the floor. That's what the really good shot blockers do.
And Bob lecturing on the far end here. Brian O'Connell said he can't believe that they didn't get that ball back.
And when Jason Clark pulled the trigger on that three, usually that would be a wide open shot for him, but this West Virginia team closes down distance with their length, and boy, he had an outstretched arm right in his face when he pulled the trigger on it.
Looks like a contact lens issue for Jason Clark, so he'll have as much time as he needs.
But that was an interesting shot with Chris Wright, with John the third, JT the third. Such an extension between the two of them.
Of course, perhaps the foremost basketball fan in the New York metropolitan area, Spike Lee, again here tonight. He was overheard by our timeout coordinator at the press table at halftime talking to Daryl Bryant, the West Virginia guard, saying, hey, you're from Brooklyn, you have to start playing. And unfortunately for Truck, it's been a struggle in this building all year long. And Joe Mazzulla, again tonight, is seeing the bulk of the minutes at that guard spot for the Mountaineers.
Nice job by Wellington Smith. He is really fighting Monroe on that low block and not letting him get that position.
The officials are letting the combatants battle each other along the side of the lane. There's a three out of the corner. Did not fall for Clark. Mazzulla leads a break again. Boy, had Smith open as a trailer. Gave it to Butler instead.
How about that sleight of hand? And the reason it worked is Wellington had filled it in the far lane. Defense had to stay honest.
There were two good options there. Wellington Smith for an open three, or Butler crashing down the lane. It's tipped in right through it up initially. Hard to tell if it was tipped near the rim, and they have credited the basket to Julian Vaughn. 4 points for Julian.
Boy, how nice was that fast break? Keep running the floor. Number one did.
Last time West Virginia won a conference tournament title was back in 1984. They were in the Atlantic 10. Butler missed. Jones kept it alive. Wellington Smith looks for help. And Mazzulla settles.
Well, he's really taken over, hasn't he, Jay? Mazzulla running the show, getting people in the right spots, making good decisions.
Being a team leader, wants to be a coach someday. His dad played pro ball in South America. Ebanks off a scrum and a tip by Butler, and Butler is knocked down hard by his fellow first team all-conference player in the Big East, Greg Monroe.
Well, you've really got to meet their strength, Jay. They get after it, West Virginia.
Monroe very frustrated, saying, grab the ball. That ball is up there for grabs, and the blue shirts are kind of standing around watching the white shirts go after it.
Now they're friends, but not for 20 minutes.
Again, you wonder tonight about fatigue for Georgetown. Fourth game in as many days, while it's just the third in 3 days for West Virginia. You say just the third. That ordinarily would be taxing, but relative to four games in 4 days, not as much. But the Hoyas were just 1 out of 7 from three-point range in the first half, perhaps a sign that the legs have gone a little bit. Only two subs played for JT3 in the first half. Thompson played 9 minutes and Benjamin 8. They're looking to the monitor here, trying to answer a question.
As to who's the shooter, I guess. No question, it looks like Butler. But they do get after it on that glass. I mean, you love their effort. If you don't meet it, you just don't walk out with a win.
The officials thought it could have been somebody else besides the guy lying on the ground.
I guess was a likely choice.
Question might have been too, was he in the act of shooting?
Well, they have to determine that. I don't think they can go back and review that. That's a judgment call.
Deshaun Butler, among his many talents, excellent free throw shooter, 77%. He gets there a lot. He shot 176 free throws prior to tonight. So many records for Deshaun, 103 career games in double figures. That's the West Virginia record. He's played more minutes, over 4,000 minutes, more than any other player. Tonight he ties Darius Nichols for most games played at West Virginia. This is his 141st.
He usually plays the perimeter or post best or better offensive player. Right now he's on Freeman.
Georgetown going out of their 2-3 set. They have a lot of different alignments to run their offense, and this gets Greg Monroe down in the low post.
Look at the support.
Now they made him catch it a step off the block.
Right. Rebound. Butler, they just look a little more fresh to me than Georgetown. 1 out of 10 now for the Hoyas. 8-point lead matches the largest of the night for West Virginia, and a chance to add to it.
They may be fresher, but they've also been tougher. They've been tougher on the glass on both ends. And their defense has been outstanding.
Well, as Bill would say, I'm not omniscient, but is it easier to be tougher when you're fresher? Missoula
got a piece.
Did hit the rim. The horn went off, but it was not a shot clock violation.
Pretty.
But it struck rim. There's some offense for the Hoyas. Monroe back into it off the beautiful feed from Wright.
It's one way to manufacture inside points with the bounce.
Isn't it amazing when, even though it was the end of a shot clock, when you take a bad shot, how it really messes you up in transition defense.
First points for Monroe in 16 and a half minutes. He's had two straight double doubles against Syracuse. He had that big double double, and then Marquette. Double doubles in three of the last four. That's what they're playing for, the Big East Championship Trophy. Georgetown has won it 7 times. Once under John Thompson III and 6 times with his dad at the helm. That's more than any other school. Connecticut with 6, Syracuse 5, St. John's 3, BC, Pittsburgh, and Seton Hall 2 each. Villanova, Providence, Pitt, and Louisville have won it once each. The last title for Georgetown was in 2007. They were the number one seed that year as the regular season champs, beat Pittsburgh in the final. This year they're the 8th seed. Syracuse in 06, the highest seed in terms of the number. The 9 seed, they won it in 2006, led by Jerry McNamara.
And the style of coaching so different from father to son, and yet the effect extraordinary.
And that's a shot clock violation.
They got it.
Shot clock violation, and Bob Huggins thinks Georgetown had possession of the ball, so the shot clock should have reset. And then when Butler had it, they would have had a fresh 35 seconds that he didn't need to go to the goal.
Boy, that's the Huggy of old, though. Nah, he didn't have it. I think it's the right call. Sort of popped up versus passed up, don't you think?
I agree with you completely. Well, it has been amazing. Cool. The quality of defense played by West Virginia without fouling. They have not fouled in this game.
Now they have, right on cue.
Right on cue.
Oh, you know the what? Billis curse.
I don't think he fouled, though. I think he got fouled. He fronted, and Monroe with the discard.
It's 2 fouls in the game on Wellington Smith. First team foul on the Mountaineers, second half.
This is where you want to be assertive, I think, Jay.
Monroe. And it's last touch by West Virginia. John Flowers didn't like that decision.
Look how many dribbles it took him, though, to get in position for a shot. I mean, the defense by West Virginia has been truly outstanding. Better job by Butler to keep it out of the middle this time.
They showed your bid at halftime to him.
Boy, Monroe fumbling, diving on the floor. Timeout, Georgetown. Deshaun Butler irate, he better be careful. He thought there was a walk by Monroe. Before championship week continues on ESPN and ABC Sunday with 2 conference championship games at 1 Eastern on ESPN. Georgia Tech takes on Duke in the ACC championship. That's subject to blackouts in ACC markets. Also at 1 Eastern on ABC, Mississippi State faces Kentucky in the SEC Championship. Championship week presented by Dick's Sporting Goods on ESPN and ABC Sunday. Beautifully designed and executed play by Georgetown out of the timeout, and Wright was fouled.
That's funny, Sean Jay and I were saying they've got to find some way to score. How about that out of the gate? What a great set.
Austin Freeman has been awfully quiet.
And Butler teeing it up with him. They got some interesting matches too. Got to keep active.
They have so many versatile defenders. Mm-hmm. Guys with size and length.
Case in point, Jones in for Flowers. I would want to pay for the sleeves on their shirts. I'll pay for the shirts.
You don't like to pay for anything. Let's cut right to the chase. Flowers foul was his first. Wright has 14 points. It's West Virginia by 4. Under 14 minutes remaining in this Big East championship game.
Georgetown has not played its best offensively, yet still just a 2-possession game.
Georgetown, a team that shoots 50% from the field for the season, that's fourth best in the country, held to 39% by this West Virginia defense tonight.
Nice.
Wellington Smith threw it off the side of the backboard. It comes back to him, and he scores right as the shot clock was running out.
Boy, is that sticking in there and staying after it.
Missoula was the guy that kept it alive. The smallest guy.
And Wellington Smith's been credited with 5 offensive rebounds. Smith called for a shove in the back. Check that, it's Jones who was called for the foul. His 3rd.
The smallest guy from the smallest state, Rhode Island, keeps it alive.
Who was the comedian who said, you know, it's a small state when they have to put that abbreviation RI out in the ocean with an arrow on the map because it doesn't fit? Great state, though, the ocean state. Beautiful place. Wright penetrated his pass off target. And Casey Mitchell's in now. He's a sharp shooter when he's hot. Like so many shooters, he can be streaky. He's number 33.
At 12 points against Villanova, knocks him. Shots down, especially from the corner.
And Bobby Subban here. Some fresh people in. Sean, you mentioned how many days Georgetown's played in a row.
4 days straight, 3rd in a row for West Virginia. Butler banked a little too hard. Smith, another offensive rebound, is 6th. Missoula threw it into the corner for 3. Casey Mitchell right off the bench and out of the score sheet.
A lot of bodies. When they shoot, they're a heck of a basketball team.
He was the Junior College National Player of the Year last year. Chipola in Florida averaged 20 points a game. Largest lead for the Mountaineers. Wright found Hollis Thompson for 3. And a timeout called by John Thompson, the 3rd. 2 3 balls for 6 points for Hollis Thompson, the freshman tonight.
Chris Wright jumping out of bounds to make that pass to Thompson. The drive to the block, out of bounds, and then Thompson stepping into his shot.
And this continues, huh? Number 8, active, pursuing, and they get some open looks because of the hustle. We've seen Missoula keep it alive. How about this little dish here? Get the puppy set. Drill it, Casey.
He towed that NBA line, but how nice is it to have a guy like Wellington Smith who can pursue the ball and get you those extra possessions?
Time for tonight's Fresh Take, brought to you by Subway. The Mountaineers, in their 2 wins prior to tonight here, not trailed in the 2nd half, despite the fact they're in very tight games with Cincinnati and Notre Dame. Cincinnati was defeated by West Virginia on a buzzer beater by Deshaun Butler. And of course, last night, Notre Dame had a 3-point attempt with 5 seconds to go that would have won the game. Torrey Jackson's shot was off the mark. West Virginia by six, under 12 to go.
Glitzel trying to post up down low. Can carve out a lot of area and contribute either with a little baby hook or the offensive rebound.
Mitchell to Mazzulla, Kalichla, Smith and Butler. Mazzulla, shot clock at five. Mitchell, air ball with a one-hand floater, and Monroe ripped it away. Long outlet pass, right. Oh. What a play to save it for Freeman.
Unbelievable effort. We saw him explosive at the rim. How about the foot speed?
That was like two football players going after a fumble.
Wright is a tremendous athlete, and that athleticism has been on display throughout this Big East championship with just 10:45 remaining. West Virginia by four. Butler stuffed along the baseline. Freeman poked it to Clark. Monroe runs the floor again. Off to Wright.
Spike likes it. How many star players would give it up like that, Jay?
How many star players pursue the ball like their lives depend on it? What a play by Chris Wright.
And right here, the long legs, avoids the charge, sets up his little backcourt mate. You love it. I thought he was going to go right over him.
Usually the guards have to keep the big guys happy, but with Georgetown, the big guys keep the guards happy.
Can we put to rest the often discussed myth that conference tournaments don't really mean that much?
Yes.
The effort is incredible. You're right.
Try telling these two teams that the Big East tournament title doesn't mean anything.
Played with great enthusiasm.
And the players pushed Bob Huggins back. Whatever he said certainly drew the ire of Ed Corbett. You don't want a technical under these circumstances.
Butler really does a great job making decisions for the team. Here he's trying to load up. He flashed and he posted up.
Mazzulla hasn't made a three all year, so he didn't take it. Butler did.
He is a gamer. They came out of that timeout. He had decided he was going to make the play.
What a quick release. From the catch to the release, about as quick as you can get.
14 for Butler, 104th career game in double figures, adding to his West Virginia record. More than midway through the second half with the Big East crown on the line. Vaughn called for the offensive foul. Oh. Might see that man on that documentary.
You
all
probably
on ESPN
hear him
Sunday night. What do you think is the message from these two coaches as we head down the stretch in this very tight Big East championship game?
I think tough plays are going to win this one. Mm-hmm. You know, this isn't so much about X's and O's as it is about who's going to go get the ball. And thus far in the game, I think the MVP for West Virginia has been Wellington Smith. Not only his rebounding, but his defense on Greg Monroe has been second to none. I've not seen anybody guard Greg Monroe better than Wellington Smith has.
Well, look at this entry that Glitzel. This loads this guy up. Nice entry by Evans. And Sean, I think JT3 has found a little use of the dribble. They've gotten some step-in jumpers. Mentioned Wright going baseline. So maybe that can help get them going.
And a shot 50% in the second half. Georgetown, another foul called. Vaughn picked up his third just a second or two ago, and if that's on him, and it is, it's his fourth. So that's three straight fouls. He had the offensive foul just before the timeout, and now two very quick fouls of the defensive end. As we mentioned, the starters play 80% of the minutes, score 89% of the points. The one starter will go out for a while. Vaughn departs with 9:22 to go with foul trouble. Flowers back in for Kalichla.
There's a concern now. A smaller Georgetown team. The glass. Everybody's got a rebound.
And West Virginia sends cutters through. When they do, that changes the zone responsibilities. And it makes it more difficult to box out and know where people are.
Oh, nice little stretch on the baseline. But we use that pivot foot beautifully. Extends the arm to get the entry. What a smart player.
And he stayed behind the zone.
Mm-hmm.
You can hide behind the zone, staying on that baseline. Deshaun Butler did a great job of that.
And you don't see guys cheat step against Smith at the other end. This is an essential part of zone offense, too, Jay. The cheat step where you establish a pivot foot, and then you beg for it. First he does it here, then he does it again. Now he steps in. And you're right, the baseline high, you don't know where he is.
On the defensive end, Wellington Smith, his third foul, right along three, wouldn't go. Ebanks had an eye on Austin Freeman. You guys are right, Austin Freeman's had a quiet night, only 6 points. Has taken seven shots, and you'll wonder, 4 games in 4 days, just recently diagnosed as a diabetic. Butler looked like he might have been hit after the release. Ebanks kept it alive, and then Butler commits the foul as he took down Monroe.
Chris Wright really got out on this shot quickly, and you're right, he got clipped.
And wanted a foul call, he didn't get it. The foul on him is his first and the team's fifth. Neither team reached the bonus in the first half. That's not likely to be the case. They're starting to blow the whistle here. Now that kind of bumping they allowed through most of the first half.
Not that kind. Like the last two times down, Wellington Smith has tried to swim to get in front. He was doing a better job. See, that swim move to get in front is going to get you a foul every time. He was breaking contact using his feet to get around in front. And the last two times, both on each side of the lane, he has been overly aggressive and has used his upper body more.
Did you think Monroe fouled at the end, though, with the whistle?
Yeah, he might have, but he got fouled first.
Right.
Four fouls on Wellington Smith. That's a big blow. And now an offensive foul called on Hollis Thompson. And that has JT three up off the bench. Second foul on Hollis Thompson.
He says it and it gets back to coach. And that's great. Terrific self-control. Something I wish you'd exhibit a little more of.
Jarrell Benjamin in. 6'7" freshman out of Warrenton, Virginia. Six fouls apiece, so the next one on each side will put it into the bonus. Missoula signaling they spread the court.
Changing the look now. Straight up.
Now they're going to have to guard a lot of cuts, and that elbow curl, excuse me, that curl at the nail has been tough to deal with. Ball screen.
With the switch.
Shot clock at 5. And a soft touch, and it drops for Kevin Jones. He has 12. He's been in double figures in all 3 games here for West Virginia. The lead up to 9.
1-3-1 now for West Virginia.
Monroe fouled.
First time they've used it. He saves it. The other end, though, the switch, they take advantage. Jones with that open look.
9-point lead for the Mountaineers, matching their largest of the night. Welcome back to sold out Madison Square Garden. It's the Big East Championship presented by New York Life. One of the feature events of Championship Week brought to you by Dick's Sporting Goods. West Virginia leading Georgetown by 9. A big night for Wellington Smith. The seniors had a double-double, 11 points, 10 rebounds, and some great defense.
2 blocks on the night to go with that double-double. He has pursued the ball on the offensive glass. He has been alert, putting it up to avoid the shot clock violation, and his defense on Greg Monroe has been truly outstanding. He's fought him for that low post position. He's not let him catch the ball at the block, and he has kept him off of that left hand and forced him more to his right when he's caught it.
Just solid contribution, and you know, when you think of Butler's jumper in the corner, he guards as well. They get very active with their hands on the glass. I mean, Smith has been magnificent, no question about it, but it's all about the mainstays elevating others' games, and let's see if Monroe can do it down the stretch.
Georgetown scoreless for 3 minutes and 17 seconds. And he has them back on the score sheet and within eight. Two free throws by Monroe. It's an area in which he can improve. He's 65%. Not terrible, but not great either. And he gets there a bunch, 196 free throws prior to tonight. Three out of four from the line tonight.
He's always looking to help on defense too, his buddy or partner. Check
out. Looked like Butler had his feet set there, but he got tipped back out. Both Flowers and Ebanks in the right spot there on a long rebound. It's a big team on the floor right now for West Virginia.
West Virginia using Deshaun Butler as a screener. He sets a screen and gets open that way.
Jones short with a three ball. Three on three, the numbers for Georgetown. Monroe off to Benjamin, fouled, and it rolled off. John.
Second time we've seen that little hesitation by Monroe, and then extends those legs and has a terrific feel. Oh, just keep running, he'll find you.
And you have to sit on that left hand and make him go right. Thus far he hasn't gone right in this ball game. And I think you've got to make him do it to see if he can do it.
Foul on Flowers is second. Benjamin missed the first free throw. Only been in the line 18 times this year. Not a particularly highly recruited high school player out of Virginia. One out of two. The lead six for West Virginia. Looking for their first Big East championship. Under 6.5 minutes to go.
Double stack low. Watch Butler.
Trying to lock low on the end of it.
Well, ball. Well, Freeman reached in to tie up Jones. Georgetown ball on the arrow.
That was very well read defensively by Austin Freeman. He stayed in the lane and was right there on the catch because Jones had a perfect angle to the rim.
Freeman. It's good. He took a shot. That could have been a 4-point play. He got hit by Flowers without a call. So Freeman quiet a lot of the night.
What an overload. Three great college players on the same side of the floor. That'll mix you up.
And they were within three. They were down nine just seconds ago, but the Hoyas have scored the last 6 points of this game. Missoula tries to turn the corner and he's fouled by Benjamin. Where they've called the game much more tightly here in the second half, and that puts Georgetown over the limit on the first foul against Benjamin.
All the deployment. Look at these three talented guys on one side of the floor. Tough matchup. Two guys can put it on the deck. Both can shoot it deep. You got the All-American on the low box, and you may be right. I think you're exactly right.
Well, he ran into
him.
Our shooter's not being protected in this game.
And Pat Driscoll took a step or two toward it as if he was going to call it and then let it go. Missoula with the shoulder healthier, able to use his natural hand. Free throw shooting much improved.
There's Wellington Smith out there with the foul problems.
Back into the game with four, but 5.5 minutes to go. Bob Huggins figures it's time to put Smith back in. He's been a standout tonight. 1-3-1 again for West Virginia.
Got to get something on the baseline. Get to it, John. Calls the timeout.
I don't know what they're worried about. He didn't have a five count on him.
Just a little disorganized. Maybe,
yeah, he was disorganized. No reason to panic.
Who's panicking?
That does leave Georgetown with just one timeout. And Bob Huggins resuming his conversation with the officials.
He may lead the conference in dialogue. What do you think?
With refs?
Yeah.
I could be everybody else has more.
Blows off a little steam. Said, didn't the guy get hit? Well, maybe he did.
Tell you what, though, he's much more subdued than the old days, don't you think?
Absolutely. You know, he has a good dialogue with the officials. It's not a bad one.
Well, he knows how to win conference tournament championships. We mentioned earlier, he's won nine of them in three different leagues, won the Ohio Valley, He won the Great Midwest in 92, 93, 94, 95, 96. Conference USA while he was at Cincinnati, 98, 2000, and 2004. And that's only in the Division I. If you go back to his Walsh College teams, they won a couple of tournaments in American Mideast. He knows how to win these events.
He sure does. Same play in the
three
sense.
In the air. Wouldn't go. Thompson crashed the boards, and it'll be Georgetown ball after Freeman missed the three from just about the spot where he made 1 second ago.
Yeah, great hustle. Got the ball back for Georgetown.
Cam Thurman's going to come back in. He provided the team some comedic relief this morning at their film session. They replayed his missed breakaway from last night to the amusement of the players.
He said he'll never try and dunk again. He's going to take a layup.
He asked Bob Huggins in all years of coaching, have you ever seen a player do anything more embarrassing than what I did last night? Huggins said no. The players enjoyed it because Thurman's kind of the guy on the team with the needle for everybody else, so they welcome the opportunity to jab him.
No wonder you like him.
And then he said afterwards, did the officials have to go to the monitor after I did that? It just gave you guys more time to beat me up.
Well, as Huggins said, he compounded it by committing a terrible foul right after he missed. Here's Ebanks out of the corner. Battling for the rebound again, ripping at the ball, diving on the floor, both sides, and it's West Virginia in possession, and Jones got a timeout.
You had said it before, Sean. Is this meaningful? Take a look at the action, folks. Just getting down dirty and giving it up.
Now, you don't want to expend energy here. Save it for the NCAA tournament. That's what really matters. Right. How often do you hear that nonsense? And let's go back to the play we were talking about last night if you weren't with us. Thurman, a little slow getting back on defense. That led to a run. And not really quite sure what he was trying to do. And then he compounded it by fouling Abramaitis. And they replayed that over and over and over again at their film session this morning.
And how about the players hiding their face so Huggins couldn't see him with their smiles? Not smiling now, though.
They can smile after the game when you win, and they did win.
But he's had a great sense of humor about it. He's a terrific kid.
Yeah, he really is.
And he knows how to play. I mean, no question about it. He's made some great passes. He's had a good couple of days here.
And despite the fact he averages less than 1 point per game, you can see how much Bob Huggins values his role, because he's out here with the Big East championship up for grabs. 4.5 minutes to go. Freeman took it away on the inbounds, and Butler's frustrated with himself.
Gave up his dribble.
Just should have thrown it out to Thurman.
Wright is open for three. Rebound. Freeman. Austin Freeman coming up big for Georgetown down the stretch after a quiet night prior to that.
Premier offensive rebounder that kid is.
4 minutes to go, a one possession game. Georgetown's won 7 Big East titles and looking for a record 8. They already have the record by themselves. West Virginia looking for their first Big East Conference championship.
Let Butler have it, because I think he can take Benjamin. Here's the switch.
Butler used a Thurman screen but ran into traffic. Numbers for the Hoyas. Clark had trouble on the dribble.
Freeman in a far corner here if they wanted to locate him.
3.5 to go. Monroe fouled by Thurman, who was afraid Monroe was going to spin and go to the goal uncontested. Pick. Everybody wants to be informed as they go to fill out their brackets. Be interesting to see the seeding for these two teams. Bob Huggins feels like they'll be a 2 seed, and he's happy with that. There's been some conversation they have an outside shot at a 1, but that seems unlikely now. Greg Monroe makes the first. Chance to make it a 1 point game if he can make the second. Mention at the top of the telecast, 6 of the 14 games in this tournament decided by 3 points or less. This might be another wire job. Georgetown in the previous 3 games wasn't involved in any of those close games.
Clark really all over Butler. He's got to keep moving.
Guarded him well off that shuffle cut and wouldn't let it get the low post position.
3 minutes to go. Mazzulla didn't get the bounce off the rim. Monroe another board. Chance for the lead for Georgetown. Wright swatted, but regained by Wright after Butler knocked it down. Freeman shut off, pulls up, popped out to Casey Mitchell, who's in off the bench at crunch time for Bob Huggins.
What a nice job by Butler to come over from the weak side and get outside the lane in order to put pressure on that shot without fouling.
Under 2.5 to go. A 1-point lead for West Virginia.
Trying to get Butler to post up. Benjamin's done a nice job on him, though.
8 to shoot. Butler's a long way from the hoop. Swatted out of the hands. Gotten back by Mitchell. Tipped by Jones. Free ball. West Virginia ball. And a new shot clock with 2:04 to go.
Georgetown is not blocking out. They are turning to go get the ball. They are not laying a body on West Virginia offensive rebounders.
Now on that play, though, I think, Jay, they thought they had the ball, so they started moving, and you're right, didn't get back to nail the guy.
Saw the rebounding edge for West Virginia tonight under Bob Huggins. They are 61-9 when they out-rebound their opponents. Benjamin called for a foul as he bumped into Mazzulla, and that got John Thompson jogging down the sideline in disgust.
Well, Benjamin likes to touch, touchy-feely. He's a physical type of player. He was all over Butler early. You can see right in here.
Oh, they tripped him.
Wow.
John Thompson didn't like it, but it did look like Benjamin stuck his leg out. So Butler goes to the free throw line. A 1-1 opportunity. 18 foul against Georgetown. Well, the other number that we mentioned last night that's been a key all year for West Virginia, when they hold their opponents to 69 points or less, they're undefeated, 22-0. And Georgetown is a long way from 69 points.
Stepping up, as you would expect.
He's done it all year. Butler's made 5 game-winning shots in the final seconds this season for West Virginia.
Back to the 1-3-1, the length out top.
Wright trying to probe that zone, and a foul called. And John Thompson agitated because Clark was looking to tee up what might have been a game-tying three, but the whistle first, the 10th team foul in West Virginia, so Georgetown will shoot 2 the rest of the way, and that is a big call because Wellington Smith has fouled out. He's done a tremendous job tonight, particularly with his defense on Monroe. 11 points and 10 rebounds, second double-double of the season for Wellington Smith. Jay, I bet you know where the other one was.
Providence.
At Providence, that's correct. Everybody gets their numbers at Providence. He had 17 and 10 that night.
Hey, by the way, this is what the 1-3-1 has enabled Wright to do. Get in the lane and find some. You mentioned Clark getting ready. He's looser, can make some better decisions, and can just crush or collapse that D with the bounce.
Officials have called it more tightly here in the second half. 2 shots for Wright. Perfect on the night from the line. 77% for the year coming in for the junior from Bowie, Maryland. No seniors on this Georgetown team. Just the 5th time in the history of their program they've had a team without seniors. 1-point game, 1:37 to go. The winner is the Big East champ.
They got the mismatch of the nice switch by Wright to get back out.
Good defense by Monroe. 11 to shoot for West Virginia. Bob Huggins has two timeouts at his disposal. Georgetown with one left.
When Butler has set a screen, he has been open afterwards. West Virginia needs to look for him after he's used as a screener.
Now Butler may be the guy running the offense now with this set.
Put Casey Mitchell in. He's a shooter. Sometimes they lack options at the end of a clock. So there's Mitchell, and he's fouled. You wonder why Bob Huggins has won so many games and conference tournament titles. He went to Mitchell because he's a scorer. They needed a score. He'll go to the line, and that foul's on Julian Vaughn, and he's fouled out.
That was an offensive foul. He just threw his body into Julian Vaughn, and that's the way it's in the rule book, but that's not the way it's called. You give credit for Mitchell for seeking out Vaughn's body, but that was an offensive foul.
And you are right too, Sean. How alert a substitution at that point. You don't need a point guard late in the shot clock. You need somebody who can ring the bell. They got it right to Mitchell and the challenge and attack.
Yeah, they caught a break, did West Virginia, when Monroe knocked the ball out of bounds with 11 on the clock, as it gave Huggins a chance to get Mitchell into the ball game. It was a very well officiated first half. Wouldn't give it as high a grade here in the second half. They've become much more involved and much more part of the story, and there have been very few officiating issues here this week. So here's Mitchell at the free throw line in his first year at West Virginia University, the junior college transfer. 12 out of 15 free throws. Doesn't get there a lot. He's more of a perimeter player. Imagine you shot 15 free throws all season, and now you're there
to this
in this circumstance.
And nothing but nylon, huh? Goodness.
Big and he comes up right back out. Thurman in. Looks like they're going to extend the 1-3-1.
A lot of driving area for Wright.
Into the corner for Freeman. Trying to drive. Shut off by Thurman.
Pretty.
For the tie. For Austin Freeman. There's the team doctor who's been monitoring his health and well-being as he adjusts to life as a diabetic. Dr. Stephen Clement, an important part of that Georgetown sideline. You wondered earlier if Freeman was battling fatigue, but he's one of the best players in the country, and he has risen to the occasion late here for Georgetown.
And the dribble does it, Sean. Drive, draw, kick, and some early onions by a healthy Freeman.
And how about the way he goes against the grain? He goes against the grain of the drive. That is really hard to guard. Great job by Austin Freeman.
And how about them putting those two on the same size consistently, and then they got the option of getting the lane to getting Clark going.
Georgetown even for the first time since it was 13 apiece with 10:46 left in the first half. Another tight one. And it's only fitting because the regular season featured one seat squirmer after another. I mean, Marquette was kind of the poster child for that. So here they come.
Mitchell back into the game for offense.
24 to shoot. And they shoot
fouled
early out of the corner. And it comes back to Butler after it was well defended originally by Benjamin. The shot clock is off now. West Virginia can take it all the way down if they want. And a foul.
Didn't have to.
No, you wonder if Wright thought they were behind. I think he misunderstood what the bench was saying to him. He thought they were behind.
Well, why would he foul with a tie game?
I think he thought they were behind.
Yeah. How could he think that?
Well, why else would he do it?
I don't know, but I mean, you just had a timeout.
Well, he looked over to the sideline.
Look at that. You're right, Sean.
Pointed toward the scoreboard. Yeah. I don't think he understood the situation. Incredible. Two shots for Missoula.
How about this kid?
46% for the year, but as we mentioned, that's deceiving because of the shoulder problems. He came in having made 7 of the last 9.
Wright's got to shake
it. 5 for 5 from the line tonight.
Wright's got to shake it off. Move on to the next thing.
How about man-to-man this trip, Jay? The 1-3-1, they've been able to do some things. They extend the floor. Huggins got a change looking.
Huggins bemoaning lack of shooting during the year, but they've made 14 free throws in a row now. 2 to tie, 3 for the lead. Wright ties it up.
Way to go, kid. Way to bounce back.
Butler's pass deflected. Mazzulla in traffic. Got it off. 9 seconds to go, and finally they'll use the timeout. Bob Huggins looked like he wanted to let them play, but then it was such a scramble that West Virginia has used its last timeout. 9 seconds to go, tied at 58.
Well, a moment ago, Jay, he wasn't sure. He was sure on the offensive end. Chris taking it right at the defense. This is power. You talked about his explosion. How about that little kiss? Good for you, young guy. Well, that's pretty. The drop step, pretty good D as well. Hang in there. And
well, here go the Mountaineers again in another tight one. Thursday night with a game tied against Cincinnati. The Butler did it with the bank shot, breaking a 51-51 tie. Deion Dixon, who had lost the ball out of bounds seconds before, agonized. And then last night, West Virginia up by 2. Torrey Jackson had a look at a 3 with 5 seconds to go, and then Wellington Smith, a nice strip in the rebounding action. West Virginia held on again. So 2 narrow victories. Will they dance with the Big East title tonight? Deshaun Butler clearly where they want to go. He's hit 5 game-winning shots in the final seconds this year for West Virginia.
And the ball being inbounded from the exact same spot it was in the Cincinnati game for the last shot. Deshaun Butler will be in the same spot. They'll run Casey Mitchell into the corner to drag a defender there.
West Virginia hasn't had a field goal in 7 minutes, 16 seconds. All their 8 points, the most recent 8 from the line.
And nobody on the ball again.
Ebanks inbounds it to Butler. Butler into the lane, into traffic. It goes again for Butler. 4 seconds to go. They have a timeout. Wright down by 2. Scoops it up. No. West Virginia has won its first Big East championship.
You knew he was going to touch it, Jay.
But nobody guards the ball to make the catch more difficult. And just an unbelievable shot. Everybody knew it was going to Butler, and they got it to him anyway.
And look at this, almost getting wire to wire. How many times in a career? Same play. No bank this time. Just perseverance.
But Bill, if you've got somebody guarding the ball, that is not as easy a pass. You can disrupt it.
Seems to happen a lot lately. So some today.
Kevin Jones and the native New Yorkers so emotional they return home to New York City, the Madison Square Garden, and win the first Big East championship in the history of the program. An agony for Chris Wright, who was brilliant throughout the 4 nights. Georgetown denied in a bid to add to its record total of Big East titles. They're still at 7. Deshaun Butler said Bob Huggins says if you want to be special, you have to do something special. This was their opportunity tonight, and they win the first conference championship in tournament play for the school since they won the Atlantic 10 way back in 1984. And in one of the East biggest decisions ever in conference tournament history. Deshaun Butler is the most outstanding player of this Big East championship. He'll win the Dave Gavitt Trophy. And one of Bob Huggins' favorite players. Bob said not only is he perhaps the most complete player ever coached, he's as good a person as I have coached. And you can see the emotion in Huggs. And here's Doris.
Coach, congratulations. You won a lot of championships in a lot of different conferences, but it's Saturday night in New York in the Big East. Characterize what this win means to you.
Well, this is very special for me because it's West Virginia. And these guys are unbelievable. I mean, we continue to compete and fight and rebound the ball and do things that probably we shouldn't be able to do, but we do anyway.
You had so many guys do so many things, Wellington Smith, Joe Mazzulla, but yet again, the Butler delivers. I'll ask you again, what allows this young man to continue to shine in the toughest moments?
It's like I told you last time, whoever didn't know the ball's going to be in his hands hasn't watched us. We're going to give him the ball and let him make a play.
Can you describe the job that Wellington Smith did defensively? Everybody's going to want to talk about his points and his rebounds, but describe the effort he gave you defensively.
He did. He kept the ball alive so many times for us. When we were struggling to score, he rebounded the ball for us and did a great job guarding their bigs.
Congratulations, Coach.
Thank you, Doris.
Deshaun, the ball finds its way to you yet again in the moment that matters most. Just evaluate. Tell me what was going through your mind when you catch it that late.
I knew it was tied, and I had a good feeling. They thought I was going to shoot a three. So I got a little hesitation in there and went to the basket. And Austin stepped up, and I tried to, like, get a little hop step over him, and I got it up in time, and it went in. Evan made a big shot after I made a big shot, so I told him I was going to make another one. And there you go. So.
Coach talks about doing special things. You have to do that to do it. Tell me, from your perspective, a New Yorker and so many of your teammates from this area, to win it in Madison Square Garden where you watch your beloved Knicks, what does it mean to you?
It means the world to me. You know, I grew up around this area, man. I played against pretty much every basketball player from this area in New Jersey. This is my favorite team, the New York Knicks. This is my team. I grew up watching this on television. I grew up playing here pretty much. And I've played so well here since I've been a freshman throughout my career. So, you know, it means so much to me just to get our state's first, our school's first Big East championship. You know, it means the world to me, honestly.
Congratulations. Go celebrate with your guys.
Thank
you
so much. Sean. One of the great players in the history of West Virginia basketball, a fitting accomplishment for an ultimate team player. For those who think Bob Huggins is just one big tough guy, you can hear the emotion in his voice, too.
And on the final play, Sean, nobody guarding the ball. If you are right there guarding the ball instead of right here, you can affect the angle of the pass, and perhaps Deshaun Butler doesn't catch it so easily. And once he catches it, you really are only guarding him with one guy. Well, one man on Butler has proven not to be enough, Bill.
How about the follow-through here? He didn't have total control, Jay. Able to armpit it back home, and this kid just steps up at the right moment. Let's give him a little onions at the end of the year. Wow, what a way to finish. Great defense, offensive rebounding, but when it comes to clutch time, wow, that kid steps up.
Georgetown had a timeout, but they elected to go without it, and they got a great look from Chris Wright. He just didn't make it. For all the day's action and more on this game, stay tuned for SportsCenter. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. What a week it has been here at the Big East Championship. Now for Jay Billis, Bill Raftery, Doris Burke, and our entire crew, Sean McDonough saying congratulations to West Virginia, the 2010 Big East champions. Good night, everyone.
Thanks so much.